78% of the variance, approximately, is accounted for in SWLS3 by that component. 65% of the variance is accounted for in SWLS4 by the component, and 50%, or half of the variance, is accounted for by that component in SWLS5. So these are all very good in practice, and 78% is really very, very high. And SWLS3, once again, is I am satisfied with my life, that question. So this is a measure of the amount of variance accounted for, once again, in the individual items by the component. And in a one-component solution, it's just literally the component loading squared. In solutions with two or more components, it gets a little more complicated, so you can't just square the component loadings and get that. But in a one-component solution, it's a direct translation, so that's very nice. Now, one other thing, when we're naming a factor or a component, we have to go ahead and name those components because they don't come out with a name. All we know is that we have one component. So our job is to name that. And what we would do is we would look at each of these items, look at the actual text in those items, what is it that they're measuring, and then see which items load high on this component. And the items that load high would give us a good indication as to what that component is measuring. We'd literally read those items, see what it is that they're measuring, and then what those items have in common, that's what we would name the component. Now, in this case, all of the items load very high on the component, so they're all contributing. But if we just look at the highest one for a moment, 0.89 SWLS3, once again, SWLS3 is, I am satisfied with my life. So, we could say, this is life satisfaction. That's exactly what this is. It's the satisfaction with life scale. And the other items, too, they all measure life satisfaction in one way or another, just as a couple here. Number one, once again, in most ways, my life is close to my ideal. Number two is the conditions of my life are excellent, and so on. So all of these items are really getting at life satisfaction. But if one of these was very low, for example, SWLS5, then we wouldn't want to use that item in contributing to naming the component. So typically we close in factor analysis after getting all our values, determining how many components to extract or retain. Then we look at our loadings and we want to name our components. Okay, that's it for now. This concludes the presentation on running a principal components analysis in SPSS. Thanks for watching.